As the world commemorates the World Malaria Day on Tuesday, the Parliament of Uganda, Minister of Health, civil society organizations and other anti-malaria activists have joined together in the walk against malaria, organized by the Parliamentary Forum on Malaria, led by the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tagebwa, to raise awareness on the disease that claims over 50 Ugandans daily. In his address, Tagebwa remarked that malaria does not only cost Uganda lives, but the economy too, as an estimate of 2.4 trillion shillings is lost annually in effects of malaria. It's at this point that Tagebwa emphasized the need to invest heavily in malaria by government to save money lost in treatment and other interventions.
Because it is calculated that we lose around 2.4 trillion per year because of the effects of malaria. That's so huge when you consider the investment we would need to put in to eradicate malaria. If you're a very good business person and you calculate that if you invest 200 billion or 500 billion, you save 2.4 trillion. That would be good economics.
Tagebwa rallied fellow legislators to use the ongoing budgeting process to appropriate more funds towards malaria fight interventions. He, however, urged government to promote other protection interventions like mosquito repellent plants around people's homesteads.
Sometimes we don't know whether we are treating malaria or not. They look at you and the conclusion is you have malaria. Now, we have focused on distribution of nets, but also if you give nets without sensitization of the people. We know some people are using them for fishing. Some people are using them as mattresses in rural areas, as bed sheets. Some of them are using them for making mara, for making chips.
Cost effective and return on investment is high. Ending malaria transmission will increase the quality of life of millions of people, particularly women and children, and free up resources that are currently being used to fight the disease. As a country, we need to prioritize resources for more efforts and tools guided by our scientific community to stop the mosquitoes, bone diseases, and death.
According to Dr. Daniel Chabayinze, the director in charge of public health at the Ministry of Health, Uganda is the third most malaria-burdened country in the world, with West Nile, Karamoja, and Busoga sub-regions leading in malaria upsurge. The Minister of Health figures indicate that 34% of people in Karamoja have malaria, in West Nile 22%, and 22% in Busoga. He disclosed that the ministry plans to distribute mosquito nets across the country, starting with the 17 districts that have recorded the most cases of malaria.
Currently, the malaria burden in Uganda is alarming. Uganda has the third highest number of cases of malaria in the world. And in fact, we have almost 15 million cases treated every year. This number has not started going down because we've had challenges in the last 1 year. So we need to call upon everybody. The regions which are worstly affected with malaria are West Nile, Karamoja region, and the areas around Busoga region.
Experts from civil society organizations underscored the need for such works to amplify public awareness and advocacy for malaria.
Every day we see, every 2 minutes, we lose 2 children in Africa to malaria. And it's not only children that die. We've seen pregnant mothers, we've seen youth and teenagers. So our prayer is that this awareness creation will continue and more people will get more information about how to protect and how to diagnose, but also how to seek services against malaria.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.